Good afternoon, and welcome to this week's Live at the 415, streaming directly from Kerrytown Concert House. I'm Monica Swartout-Bebo, Artistic and Executive Director, and I would like to thank you for joining us today. We aren't yet charging tickets for these presentations, but as we navigate the complexities of artistic performance during our nation's health crisis, please consider making a donation in lieu of a ticket purchase for today's concert. All donations support these artists featured and help Kerrytown Concert House continue its mission of bringing artists and audiences together in unique and meaningful ways. In tough times, the arts help us retain our sense of humanity and identity. And I am honored to introduce our program for you today, brought to you by both longtime friends of Kerrytown Concert House and new friends. With Sean Dobbins' trio, it is my honor to introduce to you Jazz and Civil Rights.
Welcome, welcome, and we thank you today. My name is Athena Johnson, vocalist, recording vocalist. We're so glad to see you here with us and have you here with us today. On piano, ladies and gentlemen, today I would like to introduce our pianist for the afternoon, Mr. Brendon Davis. On the upright bass, ladies and gentlemen, you know her very well. Please welcome the one and only, Miss Marion Hayden, the educator and jazz vocal. On the vibraphones, ladies and gentlemen, today we have a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful student doing his thing and making his mark out in the community. Show your love for Mr. Peyton Miller. And the musical director of this show that you see here this afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, yours truly, Ann Arbor's own, Mr. Sean Dobbins. Today, we offer you songs of hope, reflection, peace, and love. Thank you. The definition, civil rights, includes the ensuring of people's physical and mental integrity, life, and safety. Protection from discrimination on grounds such as race, gender, sexual orientation, gender identity, national origin, color, age, political affiliation, ethnicity, religion, and disability. And individuals' rights such as privacy and the freedom of thought, speech, religion, press, assembly, and movement. As recent events clearly indicated, we as Black people are far from enjoying those rights. We must now reflect and learn from one of America's true voices of change, jazz music. Jazz was the soundtrack of the civil rights movement. Artists felt the urgency of the civil rights struggle to use their art for good and join the fight for equality. Artists such as Max Roach, Charles Mingus, and others performed at benefit concerts and protests to help support the movement. When tragedy struck, the African American community, jazz musicians, were amongst the first to respond. They were quick, creative, and intentional in the role they played as activists in the civil rights movement. As Max Roach stated, "We American jazz musicians of African descent have proved beyond all doubt that we're master musicians of our instruments. Now what we have to do is employ our skill to tell the dramatic story of our people and what we've been through." Fables of Faubus is a composition written by jazz double bassist and composer Charles Mingus, one of Mingus's most explicitly political works. The song was written as a direct protest against Arkansas Governor Orville Faubus, who in 1957 sent out the National Guard to prevent the racial integration of Little Rock Central High School by 9 African-American teenagers in what became known as the Little Rock Crisis. Though not considered a jazz musician,
thank you.
Considered a jazz musician, Sam Cooke played an active role in the civil rights movement. In 1964, he released a powerful composition inspired by various personal events in Cooke's life, most prominently an event in which he and his entourage were turned away from a whites-only motel in Louisiana. Cooke felt compelled to write a song that spoke to his struggle and on those around him, and that pertained to the civil rights movement and African Americans. The song contains the refrain, "It's been a long time coming, but I know a change is gonna come. A change is gonna come." It's widely considered Cooke's best composition and has been voted among the best ever released by various publications. In 2007, the song was selected for preservation in the Library of Congress, with the National Recording Registry deeming the song culturally, historically, and aesthetically important.
But I know
yes it will. It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid to die, yeah. 'Cause I don't know what's up there beyond the sky. It's been a long time coming, but I know change gon' come. Oh, yes it will. When I go to my brother, I say, brother, won't you help me, please? Help me, please. He winds up, oh, he winds up knocking me down, back down on my knees. Oh, there have been times that I thought that I wouldn't last for long, yeah. But now I think I'm able to carry on. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes it is. Thank you.
With you and performing for you, and we can feel your spirit through the computer, through the internet. So thank you all for those who are tuning in. So once again, my name is Sean Dobbins. This is Marion Hayden on the bass violin, Brendon Davis on piano, Peyton Miller on the vibraphone, and the great Athena Johnson on the vocals. So happy to have you here, and we're going to continue with a beautiful tune. Arranged by our wonderful bassist, Miss Marion Hayden. It's a beautiful tune entitled, I Want Jesus to Walk With Me. We truly hope you enjoy. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Lord, walk with me. In my sorrow, Lord, walk with me. Oh, when my heart is aching, ah, Lord, I want Jesus, Lord, to walk with me. Walk with me, Lord. Lord, walk with me.
Wasn't that a beautiful rendition of that song by Athena? She's just so spectacular. She just tells a story, and it's such an important story to tell, because we all need somebody to walk with us right now. So this next piece we're going to do is by a man by the name of Donald Walden. Many of you all may be familiar with Donald. Donald was a fantastic tenor saxophonist. His voice on tenor sax is one that I will never really get over in my lifetime, for its richness and the many stories and the voices that you heard through his playing. He was also a wonderful composer. He was an educator. He actually was a professor here at University of Michigan in our jazz studies department. And more than that, to me, he was a mentor and a community activist. He was an activist for those of us who are community musicians and cultural warriors. He spoke the truth, whatever it was, and he was someone that really believed very much in justice, civil rights, and justice for black folks in particular. Donald traveled extensively. He went to Africa, and he wrote several great pieces as a result of his trips. And this is one that he wrote that is called Soweto, Detroit, and subtitles, For All the Children of the Townships. So in other words, his feeling was is that when he went to South Africa, that the plight of those children and the plight of the children of the city of Detroit was actually the same. So I present to you now Soweto, Detroit, For All the Children of the Townships.
Thank you. beautiful composition by the great Donald Walden. We're going to slow things down now and play a wonderful composition by the great Oscar Peterson. This was written in the 60s, and Oscar is quoted as saying this was written during the upheaval years of the 60s, where he expected a great confrontation to come in America. So this is Oscar Peterson's Hymn to Freedom.
Thank you.
would like to continue with two compositions from legendary drummer Max Roach. Driver Man is a personification of the white overseer in slavery times who often forced women under his jurisdiction into sexual relations. Many overseers were also relentlessly brutal. The patrollers that are mentioned in the lyrics were men who would catch, abuse them, and then send them back to their master. We will now perform Driver Man. Driver Man, he made a life, but the mammy ain't his wife. Chopping cotton, don't be slow. Better finish out your row. Keep on moving with that plow. Driver Man, I'll show you how. Get to work and root that stump. Driver Man, I'll make you jump. Ain't but two things on my mind. Driver Man and quitting time. Driver Man to make you jump. Better make you have a ring. Driver Man to start to swing. Ain't but two things on my mind. Driver Man in quitting time. Driver Man the kind of boss. Rider Man and lead a horse. When his cat tonight he'll fly. You'd be happy just to die.
run away and you'll be found by his big old red bullhound. Pat to Allah, bring you back. Make you sorry you was black. Driver man, he made alive. But the mammy and his wife. Driver man, and won my mind. Driver man and quitting time. We will now perform Freedom Day. The purpose of this movement is to depict the excitement, skepticism, and uncertainty that the slaves felt as a result of the Emancipation Proclamation. This movement had an extremely fast tempo with an idea to depict the frenzy and excitement that the slaves felt after hearing that they were now free. Roach once stated, "We could never finish it. We don't understand what it is to be free," referring to the uncertainty and elusiveness of freedom for African Americans.
Thank you.
heavy lion, can it really be? Hands on Stephen, don't believe it, but it's what they say. Slave no longer, slave no longer, this is Freedom Day. Freedom Day, it's Freedom Day. Throw those shackling chains away. Everybody that I see says it's really true, we're free.
Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for tuning in this evening. Once again, how about it for the great Peyton Miller on the vibraphone. Our wonderful pianist, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Brendon Davis. And I should tell you, I should back up a little bit. Peyton is a wonderful student at Oakland University, and Brendon has just graduated from the University of Michigan. And it's important that when we're making these statements, it's important we're playing this music, that we have our next generation right on the bandstand with us so they can share in this journey. And we're so happy to have them. And we know that jazz is in good hands with these wonderful musicians. How about a huge round of applause for the great Athena Johnson. Athena Johnson. And the greatest bass player in the world today. Everybody's favorite. She's played with everybody because everybody loves her, ladies and gentlemen. She's a wonderful musician. She has toured the world. She is also a professor at Oakland University as well as University of Michigan. How about a huge round of applause for the great Marion Hayden on the bass violin? And if I have not introduced myself earlier, I am jazz drummer, composer, arranger, husband, father of three, and I'm an associate professor at Indiana University. My name is Sean Dobbins. Thank you so much. I wanted to take this moment to give you some understanding of why we're here this evening and what this is all about. We're going through some tough times. Recently, we've found ourselves in the middle of a pandemic, something that we've never thought that we would ever see. We were so surprised. We went from our normal lives to our lives being turned upside down. We're getting through it step by step, day by day. But thinking back to the beginning of this pandemic, I remember noticing and seeing and witnessing the best of who we could possibly be. We walked, we talked, we thought about each other, we asked about each other, we did what we could to help each other. There is no race, there is no party lines, there is nothing dividing us. We just wanted the best for each other. Unfortunately, during those times, those lines became present again. I remember walking through the store and someone I didn't know just said, "Hey man, how are you? How are you getting through this? Are you okay? Are you doing all right? How's your family?" He didn't know me. And we talked for a little while. And all of a sudden, we're not doing that anymore. We've been told that for some reason, no matter what happens in our world, we have to be divided. And that's not the world I want to live in. That's not the world I think you want to live in. For some reason, race and brutality has again reared its ugly head with some of our African-American men, women, everyone. This is tough. Many people are committing these acts and they're hiding behind their own religious values or their cultural values, their spiritual values. I want to remind all of us that the way that we live our life on earth reflects the heaven that we someday want to enter. I hope that the heaven that you want is not full of hate, it's not full of bigotry, and it's not full of racism. I would venture to say that if we all sat down and wrote out everything that we wanted out of life, we would pretty much have the same list. We want good for our family, we want great schools, vacation from time to time, and a nice home, that's it. We don't want anything from each other, we just want a little love and friendship. And unfortunately, that has not been the case. I ask all of you to stand up and stand with me and stand with all of us as we all have children, nephews, brothers, nieces, whomever, that is a victim of this pandemic. And when I say pandemic, I mean the racist and bigotry pandemic that Black Americans have been fighting for years. To my white brothers and sisters who have done so much to support us, I want you to understand that this pandemic and this feeling has something that we've been feeling for a long time. We have been shut in. We have felt afraid. I hope that you can understand what we have been dealing with and understand what our plight is, and hope to, that you would help us get through these ugly times. It has been tough. The two last victims that were recently victims of these heinous crimes said the words, they uttered the words, "I can't breathe, I can't breathe." Well, I'm here to tell you that as Americans, we haven't been able to breathe for a very long time. We have been choked by discrimination. We have been choked by racism, and we have been choked by the ugliness of our community that is only benefited from those who start these ugly problems. I'm asking you all to stand up so that we can all breathe. Once again, to everyone, I really appreciate your support and when you're out and marching with us and standing with us. But while you're reflecting on what the Black Americans are going through right now, I want you to remember something. Black lives only matter once a white person said so. Is that the life that we want to lead? Because that is what's been going on. It is time for a change. Now, many people discuss what that change needs to be and what we have to do. I believe that everyone has their own starting point. You can think about and reflect on your church, your work, your neighborhood, your school, whatever. But I ask you to think about where you want to start to make a change in our community, in our nation, in our world. This is not right. This is unfortunately not new. But it's out now, and now it's time for us to decide who we want to be. And I believe in all of us. I believe that we can make this change. So I hope you stand with me. I hope you stand with all of us. And I hope we lift every voice. We lift every voice against the ugly racism and bigotry that we have been dealing with. Have conversations with your friends, family, those of your colleagues, whomever. But we can face this and we can fight this and we can win together. On behalf of the band, sincerely, thank you so much for tuning in. May God bless you. May God keep you. Thank you.
Stony the road we trod, bitter the chastening rod, felt in the days when home unborn had died. Yet with a steady beat, and an hour everything, come to the place for which a heart is tied. Oh, we have come, treading a path through the blood of the slaughtered. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce the band to you. On vibraphones, as Sean mentioned earlier, a wonderful student doing big things in the community. Please show your love for Mr. Peyton Miller. And another recent graduate, young people over here doing their thing everywhere, ladies and gentlemen. Please show your love for Mr. Brendon Davis. On this funk face over here, y'all, doing her thing all the time. We love her dearly. Y'all show your love for the one, Mrs. Marion Hayden. Your vocals for this afternoon have been brought to you by myself and our own, my name, Athena Johnson. And our maestro and musical director for this afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, a powerful force in this community who we all know and love. Please give it up for the one, Mr. Sean Dobbins.
Ladies and gentlemen, we hope you enjoyed tonight's performance live from the 415 at Kerrytown Concert House. Please support Kerrytown Concert House and our beloved artists by going to our website. We will continue our streaming series and look forward to being able to stream performances with live audiences very soon. Thank you and good night.